Right, you guys are not gonna go with me on this. So, as you can see, I don't have a white sleeveless shirt, so I kind of had to improvise. Same thing I did with my mustache. But at least I got my sunglasses, so yeah. It's a thing. I guess I'm Freddie Mercury right now for the purpose of this video. So, why am I embarrassing myself this way? I just watched Bohemian Rhapsody, and I think I said this in my before and after video. This might be my favorite movie of the year. Like, for real. I mean, Bohemian Rhapsody is a movie I was not expecting to like as much as I did. I thought, well, it's probably going to be another one of those paint-by-numbers, generic biopic about a band. And to be fair, though, I haven't exactly watched a lot of those, so I didn't really know what to expect. But if any of those biopics about a band or a band member or a musician in general, if any of those are every bit as good as this one, then I have been missing out, because this movie was amazing. And I gotta be honest, first, up top, as a movie overall, I kinda had a few minor issues with it towards the beginning, but that's just a few little nitpicks that I can gloss over. I think the filmmakers were relying a little bit too much on the fact that everybody knows who Queen is, everyone knows the band members, and they know how they all got together. So yeah, that whole part where Freddie meets Brian and John and Roger, the whole how these four guys put their whole band together and how they came up with the name Queen and how they started working on their songs, that was kind of short and not very detailed, but it's okay, because as soon as you get over that bit of detail, the movie just sprints all the way to the finish line and does it magnificently. The performances, obviously, of the actors portraying the real people, and if I'm not mistaken, I believe the remaining Queen members, or at the very least Brian May, I know for sure, was very heavily involved with the production. I don't know if the other two were, but Brian May, I know for a fact, had a heavy hand in producing this movie and bringing it to where it is. And I gotta be honest, I can't argue with the result, because the final product was, like I said, amazing. It is one of the best movies I've seen all year, and like I said, might be my favorite. Better than First Man, and probably even better than Avengers: Infinity War. Yes, and I'm not ashamed to say it. I really enjoyed this movie, not just for the performances of the actors portraying the band members, the actors and actresses portraying the other characters in the film. Now, I gotta be honest though, I'm not that well versed in the history of Queen and all of the stuff that happened over the course of this band's history, so I'm not exactly sure which of these characters that I've witnessed on screen are real, which characters are not so real. I do know for a fact that the Mike Myers character was a fictional character that was created specifically for a very specific plot point that I've heard of from a lot of people that was terrible. I personally enjoyed it because of the role that Mike Myers' character had to play in the movie, and yeah, that character actually worked for me. The other characters, again, I have no idea which of these characters was real, which was fictional and created specifically for the purpose of propelling the story forward. But I can say with all honesty that, fictional or not, all the characters had a meaning and a purpose in the movie. No character was wasted like some other movies sometimes. This movie was focused. It knew what it was trying to do. You can tell that the director, in this case, directors, they have a tremendous level of love and appreciation for the band and huge respect for Queen and and their music as a whole. This movie is what I personally like to call a sandwich movie, and the reason why I'm calling it a sandwich movie is because the movie starts with a very specific event that I'm not going to share for spoiler reasons, but if you're a fan of Queen, you probably already know what that very important particular event is or was, but it starts with that one specific event. Then the rest of the movie is just several years before that and all of the events leading up to that one particular event. Hence the word sandwich. It pretty much ended the same way it started, only you kind of got to see the whole journey there, if that makes any sense to you. So right off the top, when the movie starts, you immediately say to yourself, oh, okay, so this is what we're going for. Now we're going to see how we got there. And right from the start, knowing all of that, all I could have wished for is for the very engaging story leading up to that one particular event. And like I said, it did not disappoint. It delivered on all fronts. Like I said, the characters, the performances, the story around it, everything worked for me. And there really isn't that much else to say other than this movie works on a multitude of different levels. Bit of a sad note that I have to mention, well, it might be a negative, it might be a positive, you be the judge, is that I went to see this movie and the theater was empty. I mean, there was literally no one there. I mean, it's not like a few weeks ago when I went to see First Man and I walked in, I was the only one there. Then another guy walked in a few minutes after I did, and he kind of looked like he had to be there because he was a critic or something. So if he didn't have to be there, he wouldn't. But yeah, it was just me and someone else in that theater that day. Today, however, I was completely alone, which on one hand, it saddens me that people apparently don't have much of an interest in this movie, that people don't go out and support this movie, people don't go out and watch this movie, which is a shame because, like I said, it's an amazing movie and I believe this movie needs to be seen by as many people as possible. On the other hand, though, I gotta say, given the fact that I was completely alone, I was finally free to just do whatever the hell I wanted, because if you've been watching some of my trailer reactions to Bohemian Rhapsody, the movie, I kind of have a little thing about singing Queen songs, and people don't really like it. Well, screw that, because this time I was completely alone, and I was singing my heart out, and you might not be able to tell it just yet, but my voice is kind of starting to go. I can definitely tell that I'm going to be feeling the effects of this movie on my voice by tomorrow, but yeah, Bohemian Rhapsody, if you can have that experience of going there alone and just seeing by yourself, or if you go to a movie theater with a lot of Queen fans that enjoy the singing and you notice that they start singing themselves, well, join in on the fun, because this movie really does sell you on the experience of the Queen live concert. And before I went there, a lot of people had suggested that I should watch it on IMAX. Now, a little bit of disclosure, the people who told me to watch it on IMAX worked at the theater, there was this girl from the concession stand, and there was the theater manager. So I can tell they have a bit of an interest in me going to see it in IMAX. But regardless, after seeing the movie, I understand why they would recommend someone go to see it in IMAX, because this movie is an experience. It's the full live Queen event. And obviously, as you can tell, I've never been in a live Queen performance or concert or anything, because, well, I wasn't even born yet when Queen was the thing to watch. But yeah, so after seeing this, I kind of feel like I have been in a Queen show, live show, whatever. And if you love Queen yourselves and you haven't had the chance to go see Queen perform live, this is your chance. So yeah, go support this movie and see it on IMAX, the biggest screen possible, the best sound quality ever, and just go and have fun, because this movie is more or less a reminder that, you know, these days we talk a lot about politics and diversity and racial stuff and just a lot of bullshit, to be honest. This movie had none of it. Well, it did have a lot of it, but not in the way that you would expect from a movie made today. It really was, at the end of the day, it was proof that music brings us all together. It doesn't matter who you are, where you come from in the world, it doesn't matter whether you're Jewish or Christian or Muslim or any other type of thing. It doesn't matter if you're black or white, or it doesn't even matter what ethnicity you have. If you love music, if you love life, then this movie should affect you positively. And hopefully you guys can listen to me. Hopefully you guys are watching this review, by the way. Hopefully you take my advice to heart and just go watch the movie and have fun, because that really is what life is all about. So that's really all I got to say, I guess. And good luck. Hello again, everybody. I hope you liked this video. And if you did, please remember to like, share, and subscribe to my channel, where I do all kinds of weird stuff, like showcase all these things, you know, trailer reactions, movie reviews, all kinds of fun stuff. So, until next time, I'll see you guys next time.